Hello everyone. I am back in Norway after 1.5 years, close to 2 years. It's been a global pandemic thing going on, in case you're watching this in 2047. It has kept people away from their families for a long time. So yeah, I'm home in Norway for a visit, and today I'm going to share a testimony. Normally I keep my videos short and concise and informative and researched and around 5 minutes long. But this video might be a little bit different, as they sometimes do. But I will try to cut away some parts because I might go on a rambling. And as some of you can hear, I have a cold and suddenly I have to sneeze or cough or blow my nose. So I'll cut those parts away as well. But yeah, I have a quite strong testimony I'm going to share today. And well, we have to go 20 years back in time. We have to go to this barn. You can see behind me here. That barn is way over 100 years old, and we have to go back 20 years in time, and then I'm going to share my testimony from there. So let's get to it. I have to admit, being a sore, stiff, retired football player and feeling under the weather today, climbing that fence was not the easiest thing I've done in my life. Yeah, this is a very old barn. You can see how rotten it is. Oh, Spider-Man lives here. No smoking. Honey, I'm home. Oh. That is rotten indeed. Very rotten. You know, we have old farmer equipment standing upstairs. Even an old piano, if I recall right. So, having these heavy objects right above my head, on top of these rotten planks, it's not super comfortable idea. Yeah, we used to have horses a couple of decades ago. Good fun. My testimony is from behind that door.
Achoo!
Achoo!
Achoo! Achoo! Achoo!
You can make your own decision of what you think happened, if I just got really, 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 really lucky, or if I had undeserved protection from God, that one of his angels helped me. So let me open the door and get straight into it and take you guys 20 years back in time, from when I was in here playing with our dogs and my mother was out here cleaning. And here's what happened. Oh, I should be careful. You guys see that crack on the in the floor there? It's not safe to walk out here, and it wasn't back then either, because you see the gap between those planks there? Those planks, that's the original floor, and that's the floor we just added later. But nobody has really been in here since this accident, because I fell straight through the floor right there, guys, and right into the basement. It's like a stone floor. It was an empty basement, stone floor, and it's a 13 feet drop, 4 meters. Not the highest, but for the head and skull of an 11, 12-year-old child, it's more than enough height to break your neck and kill you, make you paralyzed or severely injured. And the reason why this is a testimony video is because something happened right before I hit the floor that I wanted to share with you guys. It's, well, so right before I hit the floor, I just saw the most crazy white light. It was so shiny, so white, shining through that hole. And while that, this was just for like a second, and I was falling like a reverse nail, so legs up and head and neck down. And I just saw this very shiny white light shining through that hole for just a second. And while, some of you guys may say, yeah, it must have been that sun, you know, coming through the wall. But that's not the case here, is it? And that would be the angle, if from where I would have seen it. But granted, let's say it was the sun. It doesn't really matter for the testimony because something else crazy and weird happened, which I only can explain like a miracle. But what happened is that as soon as that shiny white light was shining through that hole while I was falling legs up and head and neck down, times... Have you guys seen the movie Matrix? You know, when time stands still, Neo walk around people and bullets and everything. It's kind of like that, because when that light shined through the floor and I was falling with my head and neck first, right towards that stone floor, the planks and the hay and my body just froze in the air for like less than a second while this white light was shining through that hole. We just froze. The planks froze right next to me and the hay froze right next to me. I could see it right with my legs. And my body froze, just hanging loose in the air, completely still. And then just instantly, I was dropped again into reality. And it just felt like I just fall this high. And then all the planks and hay fall on me. But really, just it hurts more to dunk my head. I stood up without a scratch. It didn't hurt really at all. And that's what I was experiencing. It was crazy. I just stood up and I heard my mother screaming and almost crying and running out, seeing a big hole here in the floor and fearing the worst. And I just said, get the dogs out. So that's the story. That's what happened. And so many thoughts during and after that. I told my doctor about it a little bit later, and he said, you must have had angel protection. And yeah, guys, I mean, look, this is a personal testimony, so I'm not saying that this should do anything for you and how you view the world. You should not just take some dude on the internet's personal testimony and become a Christian based solely on that. You should look into the evidences for the and historical Jesus and the reliability of New Testament and the resurrection. That's what you need to do. But if this video can strengthen you, if this testimony can strengthen your faith to show that God is still active, God is still doing miracles 20 years ago and today, then I hope this video and story and testimony was beneficial for you. And I just wanted to share this because I'm in Norway now and I could film it and show you guys this for myself. You could see it in person where it happened. And what you will do with this video and testimony is completely up to you. So yeah, I'm just going to end the video there. Thank you for watching. God bless.